sending gratitude belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nahmaduhu, for that reason we praise Him, we thank Him for all the blessings that we have. Wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu, we ask for help and we ask for forgiveness. Wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina, we ask protection. We ask protection from all the evilness that is coming out of our own actions. نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له. Whoever has been guided, there is absolutely nothing in this world no one can do to misguide that person. May Allah make us worthy of that guidance. Ameen. ومن يضل فلا هادي له. On the other hand, whoever chose, keywords guys, whoever chose certain actions that was eligible for misguidance, there's absolutely no one can do to guide that person. وَنَشْهَدُ أَنَّ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَنَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. قال الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم, Allah says in His book, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, يا أيها الذين آمنوا, believers, اتقوا الله, have consciousness of Allah, have awareness of Allah, be mindful of your master. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته, the way He deserves it. فلا تموتن, don't you dare, forget what we just said, don't you dare die, don't you dare depart this world. فلا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون, until, unless you are in a full state of submission. So here's what I'm going to talk about today, inshallah, and I was inspired by a few conversations, a few upbringing in the Indo-Pak community, in Afghani community, culture, the way we've been raised, with the way we grew up. Probably I have touched this quite a few times, but there's one ayah of Quran, several ayat of Quran, exactly same way, same message, was really hit me hard this week. And here's what it is. I'm going to concentrate on a couple of words, and I hope I give you some take-home message. That's what I do when I give khutbah, just like I'm a teacher, just give homework for you guys and give you something to take with you. Allah says the following in the Quran, and I'm sure you, most of you have heard this. He says this, وَمَا إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا. Addressing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah says, what is your prophecy about? Why did I send you? Why did I give you this message? Let's concentrate on two words at the end of this ayah. This ayah comes multiple times in the Quran, addressing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Mubashir wa nadhir. Two words, Mubashir wa nadhir, okay? Why Mubashir and why nadhir? I wish we would have known enough Arabic to think about those two words. One of them called active participle in English, or isma fa'il, which is mubashir. The other one is a sifa, nadir. It is not the same as active participle. So this could be technical. What does that mean? Means this, your mission, O Prophet of God, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, is to be actively giving good news, mubashir, to give good news. Actively, constantly give good news. Talk about good things. What is nadir? Nadir means to, you have the capability to warn. Here's why I define that active participle. Nadir, it is not an active participle. That means you should not give warnings over and over and over again. That should not be your first thing that you talk to anyone, to give warning and just really make him depressed. What does that mean? Why did I start the way I started it? It has incredible impact in our education, incredible impact in the way we interact with each other, the way we raise kids, the way we talk, the way we teach. What I heard, unfortunately, over and over again is that if you don't do this, God is going to punish you. If you do this, it is going to be this kind of haram. It's going to be this kind of punishment. This is going to be that kind of punishment. You're going to go in this category and all that. Constantly being pessimistic, But here Allah says that's not how we should start any conversation. Any initiative, start with the positive. That means when you and I talk, when you and I interact on a daily basis, this is your take-home message. When we interact, we must be in that manner to give good news all the time. So what does that mean? Here's some good news. A couple of examples from Quran. Allah gives you time. Allah gives me time. And He says the following. وَلَوْ يَأْخِذَ اللَّهُ النَّاسَ بِمَا كَسَبُوا If, pay attention guys, if Allah would have taken you, hold you responsible, hold you accountable, or impose blame on you based on what you have done, what you have earned, بِمَا كَسَبُوا That means take an audit of yourself. What is it that you do on a daily basis, on an hour-by-hour basis? What are the actions that we are involved? What do we see? What do we hear? What do we touch? What do we listen? Pay attention to those things. Allah says, if I would have held you accountable for those, guess what's going to happen? مَا تَرَكَ عَلَىٰ ظَهْرِهَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ He would not leave upon this earth any kind of creature. Say Alhamdulillah for not being held accountable for every single thing that we do. What does that mean? Allah says, gives you time, and He says, وَلَكِنْ يُؤَخِّرَ إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى He's giving you ta'akhir, He's giving delayed, He is giving you time until the appointed time will arrive. That means Allah gives you chance after chance after chance for what? The way we started this khutbah, to reflect and to say, Ya Allah, please forgive me for all my shortcomings. Ya Allah, I cannot fulfill your rights the way you deserve it. Please forgive me, please guide me. That's what Allah is saying in this ayah. He's giving you chance over chance until when? Until ajalim musamma, until that appointed time comes. That means, may Allah give you all 100 years or 110 years. Until that time, you have opportunity after opportunity to reflect. That is a good news for you. You know, in this culture that I grew up, in this culture, the majority of us are here, it's constantly we are looking into the negative aspect of this religion. And we constantly say, Allah is going to punish you in this way or that way. Here's an incredible ayah from the Quran. Incredible ayah. I want you all to think about it, learn it, memorize it, make part of your life. And here's what Allah says. مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ Why do you think Allah's there for you to punish you? Why do you have that mentality? Allah did not create you so that He could punish you. That is not the motivation. That is not the purpose. It is completely goes against every single thing Allah, every attribute of Allah, every name of Allah. How do you start your day and I and by saying anything? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. There's no punishment. Incredible mercy, perpetual mercy, the kind of mercy that you're surrounded all the time. The last example I gave you last time I was here, much like air, you're here breathing air. Anywhere you go, face of the planet, you'll still be breathing air. Can you escape the air? You can't. You cannot escape Allah's mercy. It's all over. You say, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. What is Rabb? Rabb is not to punish you. Rabb is Al-Mun'im. Rabb is Al-Qayyim. Rabb is the one who gives you gifts. Rabb is the one who maintains you, allows your growth. It is completely in contradiction to you and I, the way we were brought up, that Allah will punish you. That's not what it is. If nothing else you get from this khutbah, remember this. Remember this ayah. Give you the address for the ayah. مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ The fourth surah, 147, ayah 47. Go look it up. إِن شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ Allah says, all you have to do is be grateful. All you have to do is be grateful and believe in things that has been given to you. Show gratitude. That's how we started, right? That's how we say, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Show gratitude. and believe. Why? وَكَانَ اللَّهُ شَاكَرًا عَلِيمًا. Because certainly Allah is the one. Allah is the one, الشَّاكَر, the most appreciative. And عَلِيمًا, He knows everything. Here's your take-home message, guys. Think about how our approach is. Be positive. Always bring the good news. Always give the good news. It doesn't mean you ignore the wrong. It doesn't mean you ignore the wrong. It doesn't mean that you don't touch it. No. Have a balance. Have a balance. And if you are any, you want to caution towards anything, caution toward giving good news. There are multiple examples from the Quran. Multiple examples that constantly Allah is giving, concentrating on good news. What do you think Jannatin Taji min Tahti al-Anhar is? And every part that you read, a warning, Allah automatically goes there and says, by the way, if you believe, this is what you're going to get. You know what is the most fascinating thing to me? One of the most fascinating thing to me, عَمِلُ الصَّالِحَاتِ. I have talked to you guys about this. عَمِلُ الصَّالِحَاتِ. There are several ways to make a plural in Arabic. What does that mean? In English, there's a singular and plural, meaning student, students. That's it. Two and more is students. Car, cars. That's it. That's not how it is in Arabic. عَمِلْ الصَّالِحَاتِ is one of those minimal plurals. What am I talking about? Allah is telling you and I, do your best. Allah is not expecting for you to do maximal things. This might come to a contradiction to you. Allah is saying, do a few good things. عمل الصالحات, do a few good things. And you will be rewarded. So long as you have this sincerity in you. If you don't know what I'm talking about, talk to me afterwards. Grab me some other time. This word itself is incredible. عمل الصالحات. That is a good news. What does that mean? Practical example. Allah says, when you get up, don't get engaged in prayer all day long. What are you doing? I'm doing salah all day long. That's not what it is. That's not عمل الصالحات. عمل الصالحات is what you're supposed to do. Fajr. If you can do something outside of obligation, voluntary ones, do those. And be constant on your obligations. That's what عمل الصالحات is. نقول قول استغفر الله ولكم فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Allah says in his book, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين آمين. And let's end with this, another ayah from the Quran. And I'm absolutely fascinated about this ayah because it gives you the secret for success. And Allah says the following. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ. Certainly Allah is the one is commanding you to what? To three things. Al-Adl is one of them. Al-Ihsan is another. وَإِيْتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى is an example, is another. And He is commanding you to stay away from three things. وَيَهْنَا عَلِ الْفَحْشَاءِ is one. وَالْمُنْكَرِ second. وَالْبَغِي the third. Look it up in Surah An-Nahl, ayah number 90. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِيْتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَالْبَغِي يَعِظُكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ.